ओम सदाशिवसमारंभां शंकराचार्यमध्यमां अस्मदाचार्यपर्यंतां वंदे गुरुपरंपरां। ओके सो नाउ वी स्टार्ट। ओके सिक्स चैप्टर चंचलम असंशय
स्वामीजी
36 यस अर्जुनास क्वेश्चन सो आफ्टर हैविंग आस्क्ड अबाउट हाउ टू हैंडल द माइंड एक्सेट्रा नाउ इफ यू लुक फॉर टेक्निक्स देर आर हंड्रेड्स ऑफ टेक्निक्स ओके of handling the mind, mastering the mind, quieting the mind. You do what works for you. Okay. Understand the principle, you can develop your own techniques. It's absolutely not that only one technique will work or that will work or this will work. Whatever works, works. Okay. Don't worry about it. Do what works. Important to see that. Do what works. Okay. Then he asks another question, very important question here, especially for Arjuna. Remember, after this, the class is over, we can go for a walk, have a cup of tea. कुछ भी कर सकते हैं. You can say, ठीक है, रात को थोड़ा meditate करेगा. All that is possible for us. For Arjuna. Battle awaits. Okay, for Arjuna is battle awaits. Can you be sure you will come out alive? Nobody goes to war doubting their success. Nobody goes to war thinking they are going to survive it. Fundamental principles. Okay, you don't go to war thinking you are going to fail. You are not going to war thinking you are going to live. You are loved ones. You will tell, "Don't worry, I'll be back. The bullet with my name on it is not yet written, etc." You will see all these things. But you are tyakta jivita. Only then. You can do heroic deeds, you know. Either you will kill and you will win, or you will die and you will win. That's it. So, with that thing in mind, Arjuna is asking a question here. Okay. All right. What is the question? Arjuna vacha adi ayatihi shraddayo petaha yoga chalita manasaha aprapya yoga samsiddhim का गतिम कृष्ण गच्छति किंचिन उभय विभ्रष्टः छिन्न भ्रमिव नश्यति अप्रतिष्ठो महाबाहो विमूढ़ा ब्रह्मणः पति। टू वर्सेस वन क्वेश्चन। यति ही मीनिंग यत्नशीलवान One who puts in adequate, appropriate effort. Ayatihi meaning not who does not put in effort, but whose effort has not been enough. Thought apna jaisa. Effort to karta hai, but not enough. Okay. Ayatihi. But shraddayopetaha. Shraddha vishwas and all is there. I know this is the right thing for me. If I keep at it, I will get it. Shraddayopetaha. Yoga chalita manasaha. The mind has not got established in this knowledge. Yoga chalitam. From this knowledge. Yoga meaning jnanat here. Chalitam. Mind has fallen short. Tutna, that nishta was not there. Rootedness was not there. Okay. That person. Aprapya yoga samsiddhim. without being established in this knowledge, in this yoga, aprapya, not gaining it, ka gatin krishna gacchati, unka kya hal ho jayega, what will happen to that guy? What do you mean, what will happen to that guy? Yeah, look at it. Kinchinna ubhaya vibhrashtaha. Will I not become an ubhaya bhrashtaha? Ubhaya bhrashtaha is what you will say classically. In Hindi, there is a statement. Bahut achha statement. Dhobi ka kutta, na ghar ka, na ghat ka. Meaning, somebody is neither here nor there. Previously, at least I was having a great time in samsara. Maja karta tha, khao, piyo, maja karo. Go, where is the party tonight? Why should I bother about anything? Now, after all this exposure, I can't go back completely to that. Thoda idhar udhar ho sakta hai. Some partying I do, but not like how it was before. That fun is gone. The promised ananda, etc., I have not yet discovered. The promised ananda, freedom, yogaratova, bhogaratova, abhi tak nahi hai. The old joys seem less now. The promised ananda I have not yet discovered. Therefore, ubhaya brashta. Okay. Chivnam abramiva nashyati. He gives a very beautiful example. Here is a huge mass of clouds moving towards the Himalayas. Okay. From the Arabian Sea and Indian Ocean, it is moving towards the Himalayas. And one small little cloud broke away, thinking I will reach there faster. And it got scattered by the wind. So, mera bhi wahi haal hai. Why? Now moksha is a marga alone. Alone to the alone, all alone. That is moksha marga. Okay? Moksha marga is like that. Alone to the alone, all alone. Yeah, you can have guru bhais, bashmates, all that is true. Co-students, friends. But finally, each mind has to understand it and get rooted in it. Correct or not? Even husband wife cannot help each other beyond a point. You can help, but it's all. Not more than that. Not more than that. Don't try to help too much. The other person's mind will get turned off from it. Don't pressurize. Revade, revade, as Gujarati says, correct? Yeah, therefore, mera bhi yehi halat ho jayega. Apratishto mahabhavo vimudha brahmanapati. Not yet being established in the knowledge. Brahmanaha pati, in that marga, not established. Vimudaha san. Why? Because I will die before I gain the knowledge. Before I have established that nishtha in my knowledge, I fall. I die. Valid for all of us. Okay. Valid for all of us. Yeah, Arjuna's risk was greater, battle awaits. But can any of us say that we will be there for the next 10 years? Guarantee again. Is there a guarantee? There is no guarantee. There was this great astrologer who could predict death. So he predicted his own death. And few minutes before he lay down in his bed, aram se jayega. 4 o'clock in the evening you are supposed to go. 4 o'clock happened, everything. 4:30 a friend walks in. What are you doing in bed at 4:30 in the evening? Don't you know I am dead? Can you predict for sure? No. Chances, you can say. Another person looked at his horoscope. I will live up to 100 years, no problems. But at 18, a local truck took him off. So he went to Chitragupta up there. I am supposed to live up to 100 years. Why did you bring me up at 80 years? What can I do? There was a Dasha Sandhi at your place. There is a chance of death whenever there is a Dasha Sandhi. Dasha Sandhi is when one Dasha changes to another Dasha, especially Mahadashas. Like from Jupiter to Saturn, or from Rahu to Jupiter. Dasha Sandhi. There is a chance. And you are not careful enough. No guarantee, okay? There are only guidelines that will help you. Guidelines, this time. Some sort of. There is no guarantee for any of us. So, abhi mera kya haal ho jayega? What will happen of me if I die before I get this knowledge? Kya karu? Valid question. Yeah. Valid question. Even if the teacher says, okay, don't worry about it. Jao, khao, piyo, maja karo. Forget all this. You'll go there, khao, piyo, maja karo, but after so many chapters of the Gita being over, your mind will say, is this the right thing? This is not enough, I need more. Because now your mind has expanded to a new idea. Even with 5 chapters of the Gita, the mind has expanded. So you can have fun once in a way. Beyond that, you can't make that your lifestyle. Khao, piyo, maja karo cannot be your lifestyle. It can be some break for it. That much all of us can do. I know that for sure. All of you can do that. Don't tell me you can't, okay? Don't tell me you can't. Once in a way, all of us will enjoy that. So now what to do? So here Krishna gives... Okay, now Arjuna is continuing that question, okay? Etan me samshayam Krishna... चेतुम अर्हसि अशेषतः तदन्यः संशयस्यास्य चेतो नः हि उपपद्यते एतन् मे संशयम् दिस डाउट ऑफ माइन हे कृष्णा चेतुम अर्हसि अशेषतः प्लीज क्लियर इट कंप्लीटली क्लियर दिस डाउट ऑन माइन व्हाई तदन्यः अदर देन यू अस्य संशयस्य चेतः One who can destroy this doubt of mine, nahi upapadyate, I don't know anybody else. Hoega, ho sakta. He knew Vyasa was there na. Vyasa could have done it for him. But Vyasa is not here na, he is sitting in his ashram. Watching the whole fun going on. Drone coverage, etc. was there for him. I am stuck on the battlefield, battle awaits. So right here only you are there. Please clarify my doubt of this. So Krishna gives an assurance here. Remember, this is only an assurance. Okay? A promise. Okay. Sri Bhagavan Uvacha Partho Naiveha Namutra Vinashaha Tasya Vidyate Nahi Kalyana Krat Kaschat Durgatim tata gacchati. Shri Bhagavan Uvacha, the Lord answers. He Partha, He Tataha. Tataha normally means father, okay? Not son, beta. But sometimes you'll say, na, to your own son, you'll say, Mera baap, zara samaj mein kya bolta? Bolta hai na, North India mein, aisa hota hai. Or to your child, you will say in South, Amma, please listen. Amma is to be mother. No? But the expression is like that. Partha na iva na amutra. Here or hereafter. Vinashaha na tasya vidyate. There is no destruction for a seeker. देर इज नो एंड फॉर अ सीकर, नो डिस्ट्रक्शन फॉर इट.
नहीं कल्याण कृत कश्चित दुर्गतिम तात गच्छति.
बेटा न दुर्गतिम गच्छति. कल्याण कृत द वन हु इज ऑन मोक्ष मार्ग न दुर्गतिम गच्छति. न दुर्गतिम गच्छति.
He does not come to a bad lot like this.
हाँ बिजनेस में लॉस सब हो सकता है. ओके कोविड प्रॉब्लम्स हो सकते हैं. दैट इज कॉमन फॉर ऑल ऑफ ह्यूमैनिटी. ओके
बट दुर्गति ही मीनिंग मूविंग कंप्लीटली अवे फ्रॉम मोक्ष. व्हाट एल्स इज दुर्गति.
थोड़ा प्रॉब्लम इधर हो गया उधर हो गया वी कैन हैंडल इट. यू लॉस सम बिजनेस ऑल राइट यू हैव टू क्लोज डाउन योर बिजनेस बिग डील. आई स्टार्टेड मेनी आई क्लोज डाउन मेनी आई कैन रीस्टार्ट सम अगेन बिग डील. व्हाट इज द बिग डील अबाउट दैट. Or I'll find a job for some time. Take a break. Take a break. Do some consultancy. Or who knows, that may be my new business. So, those are thoda aage piche.
Samjho, I was in love. And what happened? She walked away. Achha. Free ho gaya na abhi.
Hey. You were such a dude before you got married. What happened?
I got subdued.
So, aisa thoda kuch ho sakta hai. Usse baat hai, usse jyada kya ho sakta hai? Okay. So, things like this can happen. Not more than that. Okay. This is all not durgati. This is normal living. Yeah, these are all normal. Durgati is what? Moksha marga is closed for you. Aray, that is what? That is problematic. Nahi kashchit. The Kalyanakrit, the one who is on the marga of Kalyana. Kalyana marga meaning not going towards Kalyan jewels, jewelers. No. Kalyana means moksha. Okay. Moksha marga. Moksha. Moksharthi. Na durgati angachati.
Then what will happen to him? Tell me that. He dies before he gains that knowledge. Okay. Here it is.
प्राप्य पुण्यकृतान् लोकान् उषित्वा शाश्वतीं समाः सुचीनां श्रीमतां गेहे योगभ्रष्टः अभिजायते.
राइट ओके ही डाइज. ओके आफ्टर डाइंग व्हाट हैपेंस. हियर इज वेयर लिटिल फेथ कम्स इनटू द पिक्चर. ओके
प्राप्य पुण्यकृतान् लोकान् पुण्यकृतान् लोकान् प्राप्य having gained the lokas that are gained by a lot of punya. I may not have done that much of punya in my life, but listening to Vedanta itself is a punya. You need punya to listen to Vedanta, and listening to Vedanta itself gives you a lot of punya. Therefore, prapya punya kritan lokan, going to those higher dimensions which are won by punya, उषित्वा शाश्वतां समाः हैविंग लिव्ड देयर फॉर अ लॉन्ग टाइम. टाइम फ्रेम इज डिफरेंट देयर एंड हियर. ओके सो हैविंग लिव्ड देयर बाय यू हैड इनफ स्ट्रगल ऑन अर्थ. यू हैड इनफ स्ट्रगल ऑन अर्थ. बहुत कुछ किया. लॉट ऑफ थिंग्स यू स्ट्रगल्ड. लॉट ऑफ पीपल डिडंट अंडरस्टैंड यू बिकॉज यू वांटेड मोक्ष एक्सेट्रा एक्सेट्रा एक्सेट्रा. पीपल आर थिंकिंग इतना ये लड़की इतना जल्दी क्यों जाता है. पागल बन गई है क्या. She is just married now and she is coming for a camp. ये क्या है. What's wrong with her? So people didn't understand you. People thought you had to struggle a lot. You are running your, you are doing your work, attending class. What struggle है इसमें सर. So now have a break. चलो. Without a worry. But some people will have problems in that break. Okay. Why? Here is a nice typical Brahminical boy. He's lived a very clean life here. And he goes to heaven. And he's welcomed. Yehi. You have done all the great things. Welcome. Here, have a glass of soma juice to drink. Yo, papa. I never touched alcohol.
That is on earth. On earth, alcohol, too much of alcohol can be a problem for your liver. This is heaven. There is no problem of hangover, etc. No problem of alcoholic fatty liver.
ये लो मजा से. वाइन वुमन एंड सॉन्ग इज अवेलेबल. यू आई नेवर लुक्ड एट अ वुमन. मैं रहता था पूछता था किसको ब्लफ करता है. हू आर यू ब्लफिंग. ओके सो दैट अपार्ट, दीज प्रॉब्लम्स अपार्ट, यू हैव अ गुड टाइम इन हेवन. एंड देन वॉट आफ्टर दैट वॉट. सुची नाम श्रीमताम गे. सुची नाम गे इन गुड पीपल, क्लीन धार्मिक पीपल. श्रीमताम वेल ऑफ. Now, well off is a relative term, okay? Well off meaning there is no struggle for existence. That will depend upon your punya. Born into too rich a house also is a problem, okay? I'll come to that later. But Srimatam gehe, where there is wealth available, there is no struggle for life, they are not dependent on your earnings for their living, etc. Into such a family, yoga brashtaha abhijayate. The yoga prashta is born into a family like that. Wow. Achha hai. Or another option, a higher option is being given. What is that? Athava yoginam eva kule bhavati dhimatam etidhi durlabhataram loke janmayadi idrisham. Otherwise, athava yoginam eva kule bhavati dhimatam. This dhimatam, this thinking person, is born into a family of yogis only. Meaning, mother is a great yogi, father is a wise person. Such a family. But Krishna admits, okay, etat hi durlabhataram loke janma idrisham. This type of a birth, very difficult. Why? Generally, once you gain wisdom or become a great yogi, you don't feel the need to get married and settle down. After wisdom, if you are getting married and settled down, you are probably too old to have a kid. Like some of the friends I know, too old. You know, too old to have a kid. They got married already, but they're too old to have a kid now. So difficult. Only one person whom I know, Pranava Chaitanya. Yes, yes. He got married. After the course, he taught for a couple of years. He got married, continued his life of teaching, had a child, continued his life of teaching, settled his child, educated, job, etc. Then with his wife's permission, he came back to Swamiji and took sannyasa. Rare to see that. In all the 350 teachers of art sampradaya that I know, and a couple of hundreds outside our sampradaya also, he's only one I know like that. He's only one I know like that. So rare. But hota hai. It can happen. It can happen. Okay. Therefore, it is that. It's a very rare birth. All right. What is the point in all this birth, etc.? Theek hai baba. Hitaji vice person. You know, in South, or in Sanskrit, to call somebody Pandita Putra is a gali, you know that, no? Pandita Putra meaning son of a Pandita, son of a scholar. That means what? Father was a scholar, this guy is an idiot. That is implied. That is implied, okay? All right, my father is a yogi, all right. Great. To kya ho gaya? Yeah, the next verse. Okay. Tatratam buddhi sam yogam. लभते पौर्वदेहिकं यतते च ततो भूयः संसिद्धौ कुरु नंदन. तत्र मीनिंग इन दिस नेक्स्ट बर्थ, इन दिस न्यू बर्थ ही हैज हैड. सुचीनां श्रीमतां गेहे. बाय द पेरेंट्स आर नॉट डिपेंडेंट ऑन हिम एनी मोर, और पेरेंट्स आर अंडरस्टैंडिंग, दे आर ऑल इनटू वेदांता योगा एक्सेट्रा एक्सेट्रा एक्सेट्रा. देयरफॉर व्हाट? तत्र तम बुद्धि संयोगम लभते पौर्वदेहिकम. ही गेन्स अ कनेक्शन विद द विथ वॉट ही हैड डन इन हिज प्रीवियस लाइफ टाइम. अच्छा, सो नेक्स्ट लाइफ टाइम ऑल द संस्कृत एक्सेट्रा नॉलेज विल बी देयर. नो, यू विल रिमेंबर ऑल द गीता वर्सेस. नो, You will not remember in detail like that. No. But the samskaras are strong. The desire for moksha will be strong. And one listening is enough for you to understand. Yes, this is it. It all seems so familiar. You will take to it like a duck taking to water. Like a duckling that is brought up on land. When it goes to finds the water, how it effortlessly starts swimming. Similarly, right at an early age itself, you will take to it. In fact, you will feel you have come home. When you listen to Vedanta, you feel there is a homecoming. Hey, this is what I wanted. You have been doing a lot of things in life. You will. Why? Because you are born in a different... Remember, you are born a couple of hundred years later. So the culture of its time, the upbringing, all that pulls, and this will be there. Of modern living. Then, once the teenage rebellion etc. is there, and that is settled down, you have discovered your own personality. Teenage rebellion is important. You discovered your own personality there. Then you start looking, and you hear somebody or the other. Some dadiwala you will hear. Okay. Someone you will hear. Some tape you will hear. Some YouTube, something you will hear. And you will connect up and say, yes, this is interesting. I want to go more into it. You will keep it a secret. Why? Your friends may not understand you. But you will get it. And you will get fast. And you will say, ah, this is homecoming for me. Aurodehikam buddhi samyogam labate. Yatatocha tato bhuyaha samsiddhim kurunandana. Hey kurunandana. Descendant of the house of Kurus. Okay. Again, you will strive from there. Again, bhuyaha. Yoga samsiddhim. For gaining that moksha, you will try again. You will pick up the threads and go forward again. Go forward faster than you went in your previous lifetime. Why? Because the impetus of the last lifetime is there with you. You get a head start. You get a head start. So chances are good that this character will become a great teacher in time. Why? He started early. So chances are good he'll get it and become a great teacher also. Not only get it for himself, becomes a good teacher also. Yoga samsam dhim lavate. Hey Kurana. पूर्वाभ्यासेन तेनैव क्रियते हि अवशोऽपि सः जिज्ञासुः अपि योगस्य शब्दब्रह्मादति वर्तते पूर्वाभ्यासेन तेनैव बै द अभ्यास ही हैज डन बिफोर तेनैव क्रियते हि अवशोऽपि ही इज पुल्ड टुवर्ड्स दिस नॉलेज जिज्ञासुः अपि अस्य योगस्य शब्दब्रह्मादति वर्तते. Even a jignyasu for this knowledge. Jignyasu meaning jnyatum ichchuhu, desirous of this knowledge. Even that person is better than Shabda Brahma, than one who is doing only rituals etc. from the Veda. Shabda Brahma meaning Veda. Shabda Brahma is Veda. Who is just doing the ritualistic part of the Veda, even a jignyasu, even though he is not doing any of those rituals etc., he is better off. Now, why I said too much of wealth may be a drawback? Because okay. I knew this person. Okay. This was in my years as a student. Okay. I used to travel with Swamiji all over. Okay. Whenever Swamiji was in India, I would travel with him and study from him. Whenever Swamiji was not in India, was out abroad, I would go either to Tirthaji or Taranadgiri and study from. This went on for a number of years. So in one of these trips, I landed up at Coimbatore. Now Coimbatore Swamiji has a huge following. Among some people who are really well, like Lakshmi Mission Tools and all these people, the sugar industry, this and that. So people who are really well off. And there is a lady who is now one of our trustees also in the ashram. In fact, her family set up the whole ashram for Puja Swamiji. Very nice people, wonderful people. She comes to me. She's roughly my age, maybe a couple of years older, that's it. And this was years ago, okay? This must have been when? 81, 82. Okay. Some of the people here were not yet born at that time. Okay. So, she comes and tells me, Swamiji, I have a favor to ask you. I said, shoot, tell me. If I can do it, I'll do it. What do you want? I mean, this lady and her family so supportive for all of us. You know, Swamiji talks here, made arrangements for us to stay, this, that. She wants a favor. Of course, anything. Tell me. It's a very peculiar favor. No, it doesn't matter. What is it? You know, my nephew, he lost his father early. And his mother and this young man, 20-year-old, he is running the industry. It's a big industry. I mean, fairly big, about a couple of 100 people working. Now he says he wants to leave it and become like one of you. I want you to speak to him. I said, that's a tough job. That's a tough job. How can I convince somebody not to do what I'm doing? How do I do that? Is it fair to do that? I said, Amma, is there anybody else who can take over that business and run it? No, Swamiji, if he leaves, his mother is getting old. She will not be able to run it on her own. I mean, they will be financially okay, but if they close down that factory, 200 people will be on the roads. I mean, financially they will be okay, because the land, etc., they will sell off, where the factory is set up, all that they will sell. I said, is there any buyer possible for that? He says, no, there is no buyer available for such an industry. It's a very niche thing. I don't want to go into too many details, because I don't want anybody guessing out who it is, okay? But I'm giving you all a background to understand. I said, okay, I'll speak to him. So I said, array champ, you must have been a yoga prashta in your last lifetime, but you must have done some lot of papa also. He says, why? He says, that is why you got so much of wealth. Why? Because your wealth is binding you now. I mean, you have the freedom, you have the right to walk away. Nobody can deny that right. Nobody can. Yad ahareva prajet, tad ahareva pravrajet. The moment you get that vairagya, you can walk away. The Vedic statement is there. Nobody can deny you that right. But can you live with the fact that 200 families that have been depending on you and your industry will be on the roads? Those days, liberalization, etc., had not yet started. So it was not easy. Not easy to run something, not easy to get other jobs also. This was we are talking of the early 80s. Much before Narasimha Rao, etc. When it was a tough thing to start or close down an industry also. I said, your mother will struggle. She has already lost your father. Will you be able to live with that? First, I want to know that first. If you can live with that, I have nothing more to say. I have nothing more to say. What do I have to say? He said, no, that will be difficult for me. I said, okay. Then do one thing. He says, you have your wealth. That gives you a certain advantage also. Why? Because you don't have to struggle for a living. No? Hire good people who will help you run the show so that you have more free time. Okay? Attend all the camps. And the talk of setting up an ashram in Coimbatore had already come up. So I attend all the morning classes every day, because morning classes are early, 7:30. You are your own boss, you can afford to go to work by 10:30. Do that. So even though you are staying at home and running the factory, you are getting the knowledge along with it. So he did that. Now he is one of our trustees. And he is doing a very good job for himself, okay, in terms of this knowledge, etc. But if probably that guy was not that well off and he didn't have the responsibility of a factory, he could have become someone like us and walked away. So too much of punya also is a problem. Too much of punya because of which that wealth comes in is also a problem. Okay, in that sense. But if you know how to handle it, it's an advantage. If you know how to handle it, it's an advantage. The whole idea is this much. What is that? That durgatim na tata gacchati. You will never gain into a bad lot. Moksha marga is never closed for you, is always open for you. If you don't get it in this life, you will get it in next life. Samji, that's very big relief for me. I'm waiting for next life. That is not the idea, okay? That's not the idea. Okay? The idea is, if by chance you can't get it here, don't worry about it. Don't worry about it. You will get it in the next lifetime. Don't be worried that all the effort that you have put in is going to go after a loss. Don't be worried about that factor. That's all. That is the idea here. This is not only true in Vedanta, it's also true in other disciplines. Have you not seen child prodigies coming up in the field of music? Most traditional disciplines, you will find there are always, you will come across some child prodigies. Astrology. On the YouTube, I saw some kid making predictions which have come true. He's a kid. Teenager is making predictions which seasoned astrologers find difficult to make. He's good. Field of music, you will find many great musicians were child prodigies, meaning previous lifetime they have dabbled into it. In so many fields you will find that. So many fields you will find that if you have a strong interest, a passion in that field, probably, and if you are good in it, probably you have dabbled it before. You dabbled in it before. I remember the first time I picked up a sword in my martial art class. I felt the energy extend from my body, from the hand right to the tip of the sword. First time I'm picking it up. Why? Somewhere I have dabbled in it before. Somewhere I dabbled it. When I listened to Vedanta, hey, this is great. Maja aaya. Somewhere I dabbled in it before. When I heard music, classical music, it leaves me unmoved. That means what? I not dabbled in it before. I not dabbled in it before. When I try yoga asanas, I know I have not dabbled in it before. I'm too stiff. I have some flexibility, enough for a warrior, but not enough for a yogi. So, you know that these things, yeah. So, each one of us also, we carry our samskaras from our previous life. Some people establish businesses before they are 30. They have that knack of doing that and very good at that. And they can change when the business situation changes. They can change. Like many people are cribbing. They are COVID, no business, poor business. I know people who switched over to making sanitizers, etc. They are doing fine. They are doing fine. Why? Arre, environment has changed, you change. Be agile. Agility is one of the biggest demands of business today. They're doing it. Do they have their MBAs, etc.? No. They don't have their MBAs. MBA is good if you want to go for a corporate job. If you want to set up a corporate, you better not have an MBA. I I'm joking, okay? MBA is good, but if you don't have it, it is not a big thing, you don't have it. No. Because these people have dabbled in that business. Some people, brilliant in mathematics from childhood onwards. We are struggling over that and they are brilliant about it. Previous samskaras. You are never starting with a clean slate. The clean slate is only as far as your memories go. We always carry the samskaras, the punya papa of our last lifetimes, past lifetimes, not just one, many lifetimes we carry. That's why certain things come easy to someone, certain things you struggle over. Samji, but nobody would have dabbled in computers and things like that. No, if they are dabbled in languages and patterns, they will be good in software also. Because what is software anyway? The languages and patterns. And mathematics. Good language has mathematics in it. A good language will try to bring in precision with mathematics. Sanskrit does that. Classical languages do that. So, they also create sets and subsets and everything in Sanskrit. In the study of Sanskrit, using the Maheshwara Sutranis. I forgot to mention that in the Shivaratri talk. Yeah. The Maheshwara Sutranis, which is the basis for Sanskrit grammar, is the basic to create sets and subsets with the alphabets. So all this, if you have studied, where is software going to be a problem for you? You will take up to it fast. If you have been a Nyaya Vaisheshika, you will pick up physics fast. Yeah. So it is not that it's a new discipline, you will not be able to pick it up fast. Okay? That the samskara is not there. There is nothing really new. Only modifications. That means what? For moksha, there is always hope. So don't worry about when you are going to get it. Give it your best shot. That's the idea. Why delay it for another lifetime? Why delay it? When I heard this first verse, these verses, first I thought was, you know, I'm okay of dying because I was involved in a few things at that time. I'm alright about dying, but this, I don't want to live in the another dimension for so long time, you know. I would like another birth fast so I can pick up Vedanta faster. I don't need a break. From Vedanta, who wants a break? Struggle of life, no big deal. Though what I was doing was big deal that time. Okay? There's a lot of struggle was there. But that's okay. I don't need a break from that. I enjoy that also. I enjoy that also. So, that is the whole thing. Don't delay it. Don't put it off. Get it. Okay? Don't put it off. Don't postpone it. Take this as an assurance that if anything untoward happens, you will not lose track of this. Other things you may lose track of, not of this. Not of this. Okay? So, 10 minutes of meditation. So that also, that samskara also gets ingrained into you and you all can do it on your own regularly. Because after the second chapter, I'll take a break. I'll take a break from meditation. Okay? Then you all have to do it on your own. Because you can't get dependent on a teacher for meditation. Okay? Okay? So we sit erect. Okay, I thought in the passing, I also mentioned this. You know, the days before Amavasya. Today is Amavasya, by the way. Okay. And Shani Amavasya, very good day. So the few days before Amavasya, few days after Amavasya is excellent for meditation in the Kalanda. Okay. The energies are such that they will calm your mind and you will get into a meditative state very fast. Okay. So put in more effort at this time to meditate. Okay, so we sit erect, the spine erect, looking straight forward, comfortable base, don't look up, don't look down. Some of you are looking up, don't look up, look straight ahead. Open your eyes, look at something straight ahead of you, so that your chin is not raised to the sky. That's a bad angle for your neck. So look ahead, straight, then gently close your eyes, eyes and mouth gently closed, facial muscles relaxed, neck muscles relaxed, shoulders, arms, the biceps and triceps, forearms, palms and fingers all relaxed. Chest muscles relaxed. Shoulders relaxed. Stomach relaxed. Sides relaxed. Upper back, lower back relaxed. Waist and hips relaxed. Thigh muscles relaxed. Your knees, calf muscles, shin, ankles, feet and toes all relaxed. Look at this body in one sweep of vision from the head to the toe. It's all relaxed. To help you quieten your mind further, just pay attention to your breathing. Breathing happens, you just pay attention. Now invoke the Lord in whatever form you can relate to. Invoke the Lord. And offer a Manasa Puja, a mental worship. Make this worship as vivid as you can so that your whole involvement is there. Take the aarti plate for the final aarti. The final aarti is always campfire. See the face of the Lord lighted up in the light of the campfire. Take that campfire yourself. take the arati yourself, put down that arati plate and sit down for your japa. Before this, before you start your japa, you can always look at the situation, people, etc., that you find difficult to accept in your life, and make a sankalpa, a decision, to accept them, to accept those situations. They'll strengthen your karma yoga, which is the basis. The base for meditation is laid in karma yoga, because you want to be free from worry, anxiety, raga, dveshas, etc. So once you have done that, take up the japa. And in the japa, your attention is always on the silence between the chanting. Om Ishaya Namaha. 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 Before the chant, there is silence. After the chant, there is silence. You are the one that is watching the silence. The one that watches silence is silence. Is from this you the silent that the chant comes up, into you the silent the chant dies down. Om Ishaya Namaha. Om Ishaya Namaha. Om Ishaya Namaha. You are that silence, silence awareness. The whole world enters you as a thought. The thought is born in you, the silence dies down into you, the silence. No thought displaces the silence that you are. The whole world cannot displace the silence awareness. Awareness, there is silence. Om Ishaya Namaha. Om Ishaya Namaha. Om Ishaya Namaha. Silence awareness. Awareness, that is silence. ॐ ईशाय नमः, ॐ ईशाय नमः, ॐ ईशाय नमः, ॐ ईशाय नमः। Silence, awareness. Awareness, there is silence. पूर्णमिदं पूर्णात् पूर्णमुगच्छति पूर्णस्य पूर्णमादाय पूर्णमेवावशिष्यते। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्ति। कैन कप योर आईज एंड कम बैक टू नॉर्मल थिंकिंग। ओके, आई कीप सेइंग कम बैक टू नॉर्मल थिंकिंग, but in time the silent being is your normal thinking. Okay, that inner quietude is what is normal. Okay, take some time, yeah, but you'll get there. Everyone can get there. Yep. Okay, so the evening is still young, it's only just past 6. Have a nice time, enjoy yourselves. Okay, and I'll see you all next Saturday. Okay, Om Tat Sat.
Thank you, Swami Pranam.